Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, depending on which time of the day you watch this video. So welcome to this information session about the Master Program International Economics. My name is Julian Imaminamini, and together with my colleague, Professor Lorenzo Pozzi, we are the academic directors of the Master Program International Economics, offered by the Department of Economics of Erasmus School of Economics. And we are also affiliated with the Tinbergen Institute, which is the graduate school of Erasmus School of Economics. My colleague, Professor Pozzi, did not join me to this lecture hall. He preferred to stay in his office just to keep the social distance from me. And actually, this is also the reason why I'm alone in the lecture hall today. But still, welcome to this information session. What will our presentation be about? Well, our presentation is structured along these four bullet points. Our experience is that students in this information session typically want to know why should they continue with their master studies. Most students, so most of you watching this video, will have their bachelor's degree towards the end of this academic year. Then the question is, should you continue with master studies? This is the first question we try to answer in this presentation. Afterwards, many students ask, what are the job perspectives with a master's degree in international economics? So this is what we are going to discuss in the beginning. The second bullet point is the following one. Why should you choose the master program in international economics? So meaning that we want to make you enthusiastic for this master program. Next bullet point, why should you choose Erasmus University for your master studies? And towards the very end, I will discuss the curriculum of this master program with you. So first, let me start with the first bullet point. Why should you continue with master studies? And what are your job perspectives if you have a degree in international economics? Well, why should you continue with your master studies? I can convince you that continuing with master studies is a good option by showing you the career success of many of our former students in this master program, International Economics. I'm connected with many of my former students in this program via the platform LinkedIn. And here, I just copied part of the LinkedIn profiles of some of my former students in this master program. Of course, in order to protect the privacy of my former students, I'm hiding their faces and their names. However, I'm highlighting their current company. And what do we see? That almost all of those students who did this master specialization in international economics became quite successful in their professional life. Some of them work as consultants in the world's leading consultancy firms. Others, for example, work in the financial sectors. And yet others work in the public sector, like this former student in the Dutch Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Well, I could continue. These are additional former students who studied this master specialization. And as you can see, most of them became quite successful, either in the private sector or in the public sector. And if there's one pattern that emerges from these two slides, then it is the following. Most of our former students in this master program, International Economics, work in firms that are large, meaning that they work in firms that are active in global markets. And I think that makes sense because the master specialization is international economics. So meaning that you should continue with master studies, and we, my colleague Professor Potze and I, we think the master program International Economics would be a very good option. So this was the first bullet point. Why should you continue with master studies? What are the job perspectives? Let me now continue with the second bullet point. Why should you choose the master specialization International Economics? So how can I make you enthusiastic for the master program International Economics? Well, we won't have the time to discuss the contents of all courses in this program in detail. We can only touch upon the topics that you would discuss in selected courses in this program. So what are the courses that you could follow in this master specialization? Well, first, you could choose this elective, Advanced International Trade, which is actually taught by myself. What do I do with my students in this elective? In this elective, I predominantly do computer simulations of realistic trade models. Why do I emphasize realistic trade models? Well, up to now, most of you only know international trade from your bachelor level classes in international economics. And the models that you studied in your bachelor level class in international economics are, let's face it, textbook models, like Ricardo model of international trade or Heckscher-Ohlin model of international trade. However, these are really textbook models. They only teach you that there are gains from trade. But as of now, you have no clue at all whether the gains from trade are 20% of GDP or 0.0002% of GDP. In my elective, Advanced International Trade, we study more realistic trade models. Trade models that come closer to reality. In order to study how big are actually the gains from trade. In addition, in this elective, I use with my students computer simulations in order to study whether or not a country can lose from globalization. So are there certain circumstances that make globalization bad for a country? And quite related to this is the next bullet point. Could there be a situation in which a tariff increases welfare of a country? Well, I can already tell you now that the answer is a clear yes. There are situations which make globalization bad and correspondingly a tariff good for a country. So meaning that if you understand these two bullet points, then you also understand why we observe a trade war between the US and China. And finally, I also discuss something like minimum wages in a globalized world with my students in this class. So we all know that particularly left-wing political parties ask for minimum wages. And then the question is, if we combine minimum wages that are supposed to be something good for poor, uneducated workers, so if we combine them with globalization, what happens then? And I show my students in this class with help of computer simulations that if we combine minimum wages with globalization, we can get an outcome that is quite bad for the poor, uneducated workers. So this is one course that you can follow in this elective. What else can you follow in this master program? In this master program, you can also follow the seminar Trade and Firms, which is taught by one of my colleagues. What does my colleague discuss with his students in this seminar? Well, my colleague discusses with his students the following. First, that exporting firms, so those firms that are active in global markets, are better or more productive as compared to those firms that only serve the local market. In addition, my colleague discusses with his students in this seminar that exporting firms typically pay higher wages as compared to non-exporting firms. Finally, my colleague discusses with his students that if we globalize, so if we open up a country to international markets, that this relocates labor, so workers, from less productive firms to more productive firms. So this is what my colleague teaches his students in this seminar. Now you might ask, why is it important to know all this? So why is this important to know? Well, first of all, then you know what could be additional sources for the gains from trade. If we observe that globalization relocates workers, labor, from less productive firms to more productive firms, then you know that globalization increases countrywide productivity, which is an additional source for the gains from trade. Furthermore, this is a very practical reason why you should know all this, and in particular this, if you know that exporting firms pay higher wages as compared to non-exporting firms, then you already know that after graduation, you should apply to an exporting firm. Okay, so what else can you follow in this master specialization? International economics. Also, if you are interested in development economics, then this should be your master specialization. Because in this master specialization, you can follow this elective, poverty and inequality. What does my colleague who teaches this elective study with his students? Amongst others, he studies this. Which policies reduce poverty in the third world? I can already tell you now that my colleague does not have any conclusive answer to this question. Because if he had a conclusive answer to this question, we wouldn't have poverty in the world anymore. At least my colleague discusses with his students in this elective theories that try to explain why some countries, like the Netherlands, are very rich, whereas other countries are economically less developed. Furthermore, my colleague discusses with his students in this elective whether or not globalization contributes to third world poverty. So this is a claim made very often by anti-globalists that rich countries like the Netherlands exploit poor countries, economically less developed countries, by globalization. Is this true or not? So this is something my colleague discusses with his students in this elective. Now let me be a bit quicker, because time is a bit limited. Let me be a bit more superficial. What else would you learn in this master specialization? If you follow this master specialization and choose this seminar on trade and firms, my colleague who teaches the seminar will teach you that the world is flat. In primary school, you maybe learned that the world is a globe. This is not true. My colleague will teach you the world is flat. Of course, the world is flat is a metaphor for something else, of course. However, I won't tell you now what this metaphor stands for. You should follow the seminar if you want to know what this metaphor stands for. In addition, if you follow my course, Advanced International Trade, in this master specialization, I will teach you that wage caps for CEOs and globalization lead to unemployment among the poor, low-skilled workers. Why is this a very interesting, a very important question to study? Well, because after the last economic crisis, so not the current one, but the economic crisis we had 10 years ago, many left-wing politicians discussed whether or not we should introduce a wage cap for CEOs. The idea was that if CEOs earn less, then someone else, the poor workers, somehow should earn more. In this elective, Advanced International Trade, I will teach you that this is not necessarily the case. I will teach you that if you have a wage cap for CEOs plus globalization, it is true that CEOs earn less, of course, if you have a wage cap, but I will teach you that at the same time, the poor, unskilled workers get unemployed. Furthermore, in this master specialization, you could choose this elective on advanced public economics, taught by one of my colleagues, and there my colleague discusses the following question with you. Should a government subsidize university education if we are in a globalized world? So if labor is very mobile. Okay, so let me summarize in a nutshell. You should choose this master specialization if you are interested in this focus, on the increasing interaction of economies via the integration of goods, factor, and financial markets. If you are interested in this, the master specialization in international economics should be your first choice. Okay, so this was, I think, the first bullet point of my presentation. Next bullet point is the following one. Why should you choose Erasmus University for your master studies in international economics? Well, there is one very obvious reason for choosing Erasmus University for your master studies. Because Erasmus University is a top European department when it comes to economics. We all know that there are many, many university rankings out there. However, regardless of which university ranking you consider, the broad picture is more or less always the same. For example, look at this so-called Shanghai ranking of universities, which is a very prominent ranking. There, we are ranked number 29 in the world. In addition, according to this ranking, Erasmus University would be number one in economics in the Netherlands. Consider, for example, this ranking by this US news website. This US news website even ranks us as number 16 in the world when it comes to economics, and again, number one in the Netherlands. Let's be fair. There are other university rankings out there that rank us, let's say, number two or number three in the Netherlands. However, the broad picture is always the same. Erasmus University is a top university when it comes to economics, not only in Europe, but also in the world. Furthermore, we have quite some prominent former students and staff members, also current staff members. Just to give you a non-conclusive list. So if you look at these names, then you see if you study at Erasmus University, then you have the chance to become very, very successful in your professional life. So meaning that if you want to do your master's studies in international economics, Erasmus University should be your first choice. Finally, let me discuss the curriculum of this master specialization in international economics. In this master specialization, you would follow courses on, of course, international trade. However, you would also follow courses on microeconomics and game theory. Now you might wonder, why would you follow courses in microeconomics and game theory in a master specialization on international economics? Well, you should consider that international trade is also called open economies microeconomics. And the reason is that new and so-called new trade theories make extensive use of microeconomics and game theoretic concepts to study international economics related questions. So therefore, you have to learn the tools from microeconomics and game theory to follow this master specialization. In addition, you would follow courses on the distributional consequences of globalization. We all know that globalization changes a country's income distribution, because if globalization would not change a country's income distribution, we would not have anti-globalists. Anti-globalists are typically those who lose from globalization. Furthermore, also if you are interested in international finance, this should be your first choice for your master studies, but also if you are interested in development economics, then this should be your first choice for your master studies. In this program, you would follow three core courses. So these are courses that you have to follow. And these courses give you 4 ECTS points each. You would have to follow 3 electives, also 4 ECTS points each, 2 seminars, 10 ECTS points each, and 1 master's thesis, giving you 16 ECTS points. Meaning that in total, you would have to collect 60 ECTS points to get your degree. What are the core courses? So these are courses that you have to follow. First, applied econometrics taught by this colleague. I thought I copy my colleagues' faces in these slides because it could be that you base your choice of master program on how nice and friendly my colleagues look like. So this is my colleague who would teach you applied econometrics, and you need econometrics in order to study international economics related questions with data. Furthermore, you would have to follow advanced macroeconomics taught by my colleague, Professor Pozzi, who is also academic director of this master program, of this master specialization international economics. Furthermore, you have to choose between these two courses, either industrial organization or game theory and its applications. So these are the core courses. Electives, you have to choose two out of these four. Advanced public economics, taught in block two. Poverty and inequality, also block two. Advanced development economics, taught in block two. Or advanced international trade, taught by myself in the first block. Plus one additional 4 ECTS points master level course offered by Erasmus School of Economics. And I think this is a very good feature of this master program, of this master specialization. Because it could be that you are predominantly interested in international economics, but your second interest is, for example, marketing or financial economics. Of course, I hope that you are only interested in international economics, but it could be that you're also interested in, let's say, marketing. Then you can choose 1/4 ECTS points master level course offered by my colleagues from the marketing department. Furthermore, you have to choose two seminars, one seminar in block three, one seminar in block four. And towards the very end, you have to write your master's thesis. So just in a nutshell, the core courses, so these are the courses you have to follow, teach you necessary and quite general economics skills and knowledge. So these core courses are not necessarily focused on international economics. They teach you general, both theoretical and empirical techniques. The electives, they focus more on international economics. They give you a deeper understanding of international economics topics, and they prepare you for the seminars. The seminars focus even more on international economics related topics, and the seminars are special in the sense that during seminars, it is not the case that your professor stands in front and teaches you what is right, what is wrong, but during seminars, it is expected that you participate in the seminar by writing a seminar paper, by presenting your seminar paper, and by discussing. In your master's thesis, which you should write in block four and block five, so towards the end of the academic year, you should show that you master certain skills and knowledge, and that you can correctly conduct and interpret your own scientific research. The emphasis maybe is on scientific research, meaning that for the master's thesis, it is not sufficient to just write a literature overview, but instead, in your master's thesis, you should generate new insights and evidence. And here maybe the emphasis is on evidence because most students decide to write an empirical master's thesis, so meaning that students collect some international economics related data to answer a certain question. In general, the curriculum of this master specialization is characterized by flexibility, meaning that you can combine your master studies in this program with an internship. For example, in ministries or in international organizations or in firms from the private sector. There are students, for example, who write their thesis in cooperation with a firm from the private sector. However, the emphasis is on internships are possible. So meaning that those students who write their thesis in cooperation with a company, for example, typically need a bit longer to graduate. The same holds for a semester abroad. You can go abroad within this master program. However, very often students that go abroad graduate a bit later because those courses that you follow abroad at one of our partner universities not necessarily counts for the master program here. But at least we have very attractive partner universities both within as well as outside Europe. Concerning the career prospects, this master program prepares you for a successful career both in the private as well as in the public sector. And this is now an advantage of recording this information session, because now you can go back to the beginning of my presentation and then you can see that my former students in this master specialization became very successful as consultants, bankers, managers, policy advisors or researchers. Towards the very end, a small word of warning. So this master specialization, international economics, is not necessarily considered as the easiest master program because we demand a lot from you. However, you shouldn't be frightened of this statement that we demand a lot of you, because demanding much of you basically means that we provide a very challenging atmosphere to our students. And as I explained to you, the insights that you would gain from this master specialization are useful almost everywhere. And if you have any additional questions concerning this master specialization, then please feel free to contact either my colleague, Professor Pozzi, who is also academic director of this master program, or myself. I'm also academic director of this master program. Towards the very end, if hopefully I convinced you that this master specialization should be at least among your first choices, please do not forget to apply by the application deadline at latest. So if you have these degrees, then your application deadline should be the 1st of May. If you did your bachelor studies at Erasmus School of Economics, then your application deadline is the 1st of August. If you have any more detailed questions about admission requirements, then you can also contact the friendly ladies and gentlemen at the admission office, and you find their contact details if you go to this site. Well, this was my presentation about this master specialization. Now let me go back to the beginning. If we had a session where you are present in the lecture hall, I would now ask you, do you have any remaining questions concerning the master specialization international economics? Of course, you are not present now, but my experience tells me that typically potential students ask me at this point, for example, how many students typically study in this master specialization? Well, the answer is that about 70 to 80 students study in this master specialization each year. So 70 to 80 students, and we have about 25 faculty members, about 25 professors at my department. So I would say this is a very good number, 70 to 80 students divided by 25 professors. Another question students typically ask at this point in time is, how international is this program? Well, international is not only in the name of the program, but this program is also quite international concerning the composition of students. Typically about half of the students in this program are from the Netherlands, whereas the other half comes from abroad, both from inside Europe, but also from outside Europe, basically from all continents of the world. So these are typically the questions that I get at the end of my presentation. Unfortunately, I cannot ask you whether you have any additional questions, but if you have, please feel free to contact either of us. Thanks for your attention and good luck with your decision.